iQuadJacks.com. My name is Toby Block, and I'm sitting here with my friend Johannes Meyer, also known as Jossel2008 online. Is that correct?
That's
or is it Jossel?
Correct. Yes.
Okay.
It doesn't matter. Jossel, whatever.
Yeah, we talk about online poker a little bit later. I think you had some success this year and last year online. Now you just. You had, right?
We could talk about it later.
Okay, maybe we find out about this latest downswing, but I'm sure. You just busted out of the $3,000 six max tournament that you have played.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that event and why did you bust?
Why did I bust? I think I busted because I was tilted. And about the event, it seemed pretty tough. It seemed tougher than I'd expect, but then again, I saw a table with, you know, three old guys with cowboy hats and stuff, so, you know, it's probably soft enough to make decent money. I don't know.
Okay.
It's a fun event anyway, because of the six max.
So what happened? Why did you bust? How was the dynamic at the table? What was going on?
Basically, I had just made a pretty big bluff, sort of repping only a set, and a guy had trapped with something which was really strange. I still don't know what he had. Probably he just had an overpair.
What was the hand? You can
okay,
tell us.
So yeah, sorry. So the hand was he open raises under the gun. I flat with ace queen, and Norwegian guy who he was on high stakes poker once. I don't know his name.
I think it's Andreas Højvold.
Yes.
Friend of
QuadJacks. So he flats behind me. And flop comes sort of low card. I think nine high, something like that. Guy checks. No, guy bets. I call because I'm sort of already planning to rep some stuff later on in the hand. Also thinking the guy behind me can't do too much about it. So I call and... guy behind me calls, Andreas, is that his name? Yeah. So, on a turn, somewhat insignificant card, I can't remember, under the gun checks, and now I want to rep my set, obviously, so I just make a big bet. Andreas thinks for a while and folds. It's sort of interesting because I think I look very strong because the guy behind me, he also would flat a set and he could have an overpair and stuff is going on there. So I look extremely strong and under the gun just chips all in and I'm just like, what do you have? And I got a fold, of course,
right.
And can't even beat ace-king suited. Or
right.
There was a flush draw on the turn.
Oh,
so, yeah, that was that.
Do people sometimes overthink in live poker too much? Things like you just explained, like I want to rep this, and if I look so strong when I bet on the turn, so they have to fold. But do they really fold often enough to make this a good play?
Yeah, well, I sort of when I play poker, I sort of play my ranges. So whenever I have value hands, I try to find some good hands to bluff with, and I just bluff them. And you know, some people. Basically, some people fold too much, some people call too much.
Right.
But whatever they do, they'll always run into either a bluff by me or a value hand.
Right.
So they can't really like do much about it.
Right.
So that's basically how I play against unknowns.
Mm-hmm.
So when I say like I look very strong, it means that my value range is very strong.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, but people do overthink stuff a lot in mm-hmm. live poker, so.
Right.
Or in poker in general.
Right.
So yeah.
So how does it work so far? Like you've been an online player. You have a lot of experience playing weak ranges and stuff. Now you
yes.
come here to the World Series of Poker. Does it really work the same way as it works online, or do you have to really like tighten up your game?
It sort of works the same as online. It's actually interesting because the WSOP, a lot of American guys are playing. And a lot of these guys haven't played in 2 years or something, or haven't played online in 2 years. So I think the online game has sort of surpassed them.
Mm-hmm.
So I think online guys that play online, that get to play online, they're a lot better than the Americans that haven't played in a while.
Mm-hmm.
So that's obviously great for me.
Mm-hmm.
Because they play like they used to play in 2000 and whatever it was, 2011.
Right.
So.
Mm-hmm. What about things like body language? tells that some of the old schoolers probably have more experience in. Isn't that a factor that kind of increases their EV and kind of makes up for the technical disadvantage they have against against those players like you or other online players?
I think it makes up a small bit. I think they could be wrong sort of interpreting body language sometimes because they don't understand what I'm thinking or what online guys are thinking. So they could misinterpret stuff, but I think it's definitely a factor. And I honestly think I'm giving off some stuff and probably they can take some advantage of it.
How do you work on that?
I try to do the same thing all the time, but I notice it doesn't... Some of the time I don't do the same thing and I give off stuff. It's just, you know, it's emotional reactions, so there's not much to be done about it, except on, you know, practice doing the same thing all the time.
You try to become a robot, like...
Yeah, I tried that for a while. People started making fun of me. I used to do put the chips in like this.
Right. And that looks like so silly that you stopped doing it after a while?
Pretty much, yeah. Now I just sort of do this.
All right. Okay, Jossel2008 is your name online.
Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about your success or your online poker career. I think you have played a lot of heads up sit and goes, turbo heads up sit and goes, and hyper turbo heads up sit and goes. Why did you make the decision to play hyper turbo heads up sit and goes?
Basically, I was too bad for turbos.
I see.
I was. So I tried hypers and it took me a long while to get good at them, but now I'm pretty good at them. So that's nice. Now I'm getting into turbos. They're really interesting. They have more post-flop play and not as much mathematical stuff, more sort of logical stuff. So they're really fun.
Two days ago, we had the 10K Heads Up Championship here, which was won by Mark Radoja.
Yeah.
And I think this, this format is pretty close to what you play online. So what do you think about Mark Radoja?
I played him in the first round.
Oh, you played him in the first round.
I don't want to comment too much because I want to play him online. I thought I had an edge in the first match, but, you know.
How fast did you figure that out, that you had an edge?
I didn't know who he was online, so it took me... It still only took me like 15 minutes, and I just saw some stuff, and
Wait, you tell me that it took you 15 minutes to play him, and you knew who he was online?
No. Oh, it took
me
15 minutes to figure out that I had a clear edge.
Oh, okay. All right. So what was he doing that was not optimal?
He was...
Come on.
I can't.
He played
comment
too loose.
Too much. I just, you know, saw a few showdowns, saw a few plays he made, and was pretty sure they were very likely not to be good. And, you know, you can categorize some people, so me playing heads up, I'm pretty good at that, so I had a pretty good idea how he plays.
All right. Confident as always. So let me know, like, many people at home are pretty much wondering how it is when you are coming to the World Series of Poker and there are a lot of your opponents that you play on a daily basis online showing up here as well. Is it for you something interesting to find out, like, who's the man behind the screen name? Have you met any players that you played online and say, hey, I'm Jossel?
Yes, I have met a few. I gotta say, though, I'm not actually friends with a lot of poker players for some reason, so it's sort of interesting, but then again, it's sort of... They're just people.
Right.
And also, you don't want to get too friendly with people that you're going to play online, because it sometimes gets you in tough situations where you're friends with someone, but you want to play him. So it happened a few times, so I sort of... I'm a small bit careful with that. Not sure if it's maybe just a bit paranoid.
You got to play hard against your friends. I think that's one of the basic poker.
Yeah, if you're very good friends, you gotta really give it all.
So who have you met for now? Have you met like Pistons 87?
I have met him. He was at my table actually.
Oh. Very nice.
Online anymore, so.
Right.
I think we can become friends.
Right. You can become friends, and you play even harder in your home games. So. Final word about the World Series of Poker. What's the most fascinating thing about the World Series? Do you really enjoy it? What do you enjoy most being here? I think it's your first time.
Yeah, well, I expect more, to be honest, but I think if you bust in day ones a lot, it's sort of, you have a lot of free time on your hands. So I think it's pretty good. Like Americans are really enthusiastic about poker, so that's pretty cool when you see that. You're sitting at a table and someone's just really enthusiastic. In Europe, everyone's sort of, you know, worn out or whatever, like, or really serious about it. And, yeah.
All right. So that seems cool. Like, in other words, you're saying you really enjoy playing against all these players here in all those big fields.
Yes.
I guess.
Yes.
Awesome. Johannes, okay. Thank you very much for this interview.
You're welcome.
It was nice talking to you. And here's my handshake, like every
time.
Good luck for the rest of the series.
Man.
There you go. Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you. QuadJacks.com. Take care, guys.